There are so many maneuvers for delivery of the aftercoming head of breach. So, which one should you choose? All the reported maneuvers have been developed over decades of experience and common sense. There is very little published evidence, and specifically, there are no randomized controlled trials to support the use of one maneuver in preference over another. Properly trained and skilled obstetricians should be aware of the correct use of these maneuvers and their risks and complications.
Hello, I am Professor Ajit Virkud from Mumbai, India. Modern OBGYN is a new e-learning channel that aims at teaching the basics of obstetrics and gynecology. This channel is meant for undergraduate and postgraduate students appearing for USMLE, MBBS, MS, DGO, DFP, FICOG examinations. It is also a worthwhile information source for maternity nursing students and practicing obstetricians and gynecologists.
Hello, citizens of the internet. Today, in this short basic obstetrics topic, I am going to discuss Morozov-Smiley-Wyeth maneuver for delivery of the aftercoming head of breech. First, I will discuss its historical aspects and describe the original maneuver and its modification. Then, I will show a video demonstration on a mannequin and delivery of the aftercoming head of breech in an actual case. The birthing maneuver is named after three celebrated obstetricians, namely Morozov, Smiley, and Wyeth. François Morozov was a leading obstetrician in 17th century Europe. Besides being famous for describing the maneuver, he also gave a description of tubal ectopic pregnancy in his book on obstetrics science. He was known for introducing the practice of puncturing the amniotic sac to arrest bleeding in minor degree of placenta previa. William Smiley, yes, his name is pronounced Smiley and not Smelly, was a Scottish obstetrician whose contributions to obstetrics are immense. He made the art of obstetrics more scientific. He described the mechanism of normal labor, designed a pair of obstetric forces, and described this maneuver for delivery of the aftercoming head of breech. He also invented what he called a machine, which was a mannequin for showing obstetrical maneuvers. He was a good painter and is believed to have painted his own portrait. Gustav Wyeth was a German obstetrician who is also given credit for describing the maneuver. He had written a book on diseases of the female sex organs. For the sake of repetition, I will not describe the original method in detail. Suffice it to say that in the original maneuver, one or two fingers of the hand that supports the trunk from below are introduced into the baby's mouth. The original MSV maneuver is seldom used in modern obstetrics because of the following disadvantages. The middle finger, which is introduced in the baby's mouth during traction, can cause dislocation of the jaw and sometimes split mentum. Therefore, a modified MSV maneuver called as the jaw flexion shoulder traction maneuver is used, which I will describe now. In the modified MSV maneuver, the trunk of the fetus is held astride the right arm like a saddle. The index and middle fingers of this hand are placed on the baby's cheekbones. Remember, no finger is placed in the baby's mouth. The other hand is placed on the fetal back with the index and ring finger hooking the shoulders. The middle finger is placed on the baby's occiput as shown in the diagram here. holding the baby in this manner, at the height of a uterine contraction, a firm downward traction is applied, and at the same time, the baby's head is gently flexed towards the chest to bring the baby's head down until the hairline is visible anteriorly and the chin is delivered posteriorly. At this juncture, the fetal trunk is elevated towards the mother's abdomen until the mouth and the nose are free. Thus, effectively, the aftercoming head of breech is delivered by flexion. Remember, in this maneuver, suprapubic pressure by an assistant is essential to assist flexion and descent of the aftercoming head. And now I will give a demonstration of the MSV maneuver on a mannequin. This is a video of skills demonstration of MSV maneuver in an actual case. This is the end of my short e-lecture on modified MSV maneuver. If you want to know more about assisted vaginal breech delivery, read my book Modern Obstetrics. I also have other OBGYN books that may be of interest for you. These are shown here. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to my new channel called Modern OBGYN.